Today we're getting experimental on one of my personal bikes, the Banshee Paradox. There's a couple of you that no matter what video I release, your comment is, does it work as a mullet? Can you mullet it? I want to see a mullet version. So for those of you who don't know what a mullet is in this day and age, in bike terms, it's when you run a 29 front wheel and a 27.5 rear wheel. I've experimented with mullets quite a bit. I just haven't filmed it much on this channel. So for all of you mullet lovers, this video is for you. I really like mullets in steep chutes where you're dropping into these really steep chutes. Chutes that are so steep, you can hardly walk down them with like catch berms or successive turns or really steep technical fast stuff. I feel like the steepness overcomes the slower rolling rear wheel and it makes it kind of come alive that way. Where I don't love mullets is on long trails where I have to pedal to the top or flowy ribbons of single track. I just feel like the back wheel is a little sluggish and it's not as quick as if it were a true 29er. So 99% of the time when I run this bike, it's in the 29 mode. I run a 29 by 2.3 front and rear and I'm very happy with that. Lately, I've been experimenting with 27.5 plus on this frame, and it's got some good characteristics. It likes to manual more. It likes to pop up a little bit more. It's got a little more of a playful attitude, but it's slower, and I feel the front kind of getting stuck in holes. So today, we're going to get experimental and see what it's like if I run a mullet plus setup, so a 29 by 3.0 in the front and a 27.5 by 3.0 in the rear. This ought to be interesting. This calls for my massive set of Mitutoyo calipers. These are far more accurate than we need, but these rock. So what I want to see now is how tall a 27.5 by 3.0 tire actually is, because we know it's not actually 27.5 inches tall. Let's see. This is going to be hard to do. That's 722 millimeters. Or 28.42 inches. Pretty interesting. It's only a half inch smaller diameter than a 29er's. Just for curiosity's sake, I'm gonna measure a 29er by 2.3. And remember, not all tires are created equal, so this Specialized will measure different than a Maxxis. 29.06. All right, that one actually came out pretty close to 29. Now we're gonna take the massive ICAN F945 wheel with the massive Bontrager SE4 29 by 3.0 tire and put it on the front of this bike. This is really exciting. That is tight. Is that even gonna fit in this fork? Let's see. Oh no, it doesn't fit. Another thing to mention, when you're experimenting, and even if your tire has clearance at the arch, you need to make sure it doesn't rub the crown at full bottom out or it will stop you instantly. And full bottom out is the last time you want your front tire to lock. Darn, I was afraid of that. Tire's too tall for this. Let's see how tall it is. 30.15 inches tall. Or 766 millimeters. That's significant. So this tire is 44 millimeters taller than the last one. We'll cut that in half to get the radius, that's 22 millimeters. For every 20 millimeters of axle to crown you grow, the head angle gets slacker by half a degree. So this should technically be half a degree slacker. I'm probably gonna have to swap my RockShox Pike onto here because those do fit 29 by 3.0s on them. And really the biggest limitation usually on running 29 by 3.0s is their height, not the width. The height's the problem. It usually buzzes the seat tube or the top of the arch in this case. That is a big visual difference between the two. Man, I'm really bummed that this doesn't clear the arch. I'm gonna see if it clears the crown. I'm starting to think about sanding this down. That's a bad idea. All right. At full bottom out, we're not rubbing. Got a few millimeters of clearance in there. Well, that's good to know on the helm that the arch bottoms out before the crown does. Not recommended. Don't do what I do. If you hurt yourself repeating what I do, it's your own fault. If I hurt myself, it's my own fault. Here's another thing you should never do. Never put sandpaper on your tire and rub it past the arch. It seems crazy what I'm doing, but I really want to keep running this fork on 29 plus. I've got some awesome 29 plus bikes coming in soon, and I want to be able to run this helm. It's kind of my go-to demo fork that I use for everything. So to take off a millimeter of paint on a magnesium arch, not a big deal. I'm gonna call that good, especially for an experiment. Okay, so I'm really excited to ride this bike now. Here we are in full experimental mode. We got the Atomik Chubby rear wheel with these amazing berd spokes, which give it some nice compliance. 27.5 by 3.0 rear tire, which has very minimal clearance on this frame, but it does clear. 29 by 3.0 up front, which clears, sorta. But yeah, it's slackened it out some. It's raised the bottom bracket a little over the 27.5 plus mode, but it's lower than in 29er mode. It brought the front end up, so the stack's a little taller. All of these are good things. The seat angle's a little bit slacker than in full 29er mode, but that's not a problem. This bike has a super steep seat angle. This bike is the reason almost every review bike I hop on, I say, I wish the seat angle was steeper, because I love how this seat angle feels. Next up, we need to take this to the trails and see what it actually rides like, and if I've made this bike even worse or even better. My hypothesis, I think this is gonna be better. The one thing I don't love about 27.5 front and back is the front gets stuck into holes. When you're used to 29ers, you can punch through stuff. And I know it's only like 3/4 of an inch difference in height, but you feel that. It really does roll through holes and ledgy square edge hits better. And I think this is gonna be even better than a 29er because it's really a 30.1er with how tall that is. Anyway, thanks for getting experimental with me. What do you think is gonna happen? Am I gonna love it? Am I gonna die because I'm gonna bottom out the fork and get pitched over the front? Am I gonna sweat up all my bikes, mullet? What would you be interested in? How would you set yours up if you got experimental? Thanks for watching. There's a party in the mountains and you're invited.